Here's the Fox News alert for you. This will be a headline today. The Attorney General Eric Holder set to make a major policy change that will basically do away with mandatory sentences for some low-level nonviolent drug offenders. But is Holder blaming the system instead of the people who actually break the law? Ro Khan is the host of Ro and Roper and is a contributor for Windy City Live. And Leslie Marshall is a syndicated radio talk show host and a Fox News contributor. And we welcome both of you here. This is part of the argument the AG will make on screen for our viewers. Quote, a vicious cycle of poverty, criminality, and incarceration traps too many Americans and weakens too many communities. However, many aspects of our criminal justice system may actually exacerbate this problem rather than alleviate it. Ro, start. What do you think?
Well, I think this is why he's the wrong messenger for this, quite honestly, because what he's doing is he's making this rather political when it's really a practical reality. Can we afford our morality any longer? And we face it, we can't send out carrier groups into the Mediterranean, right? Because we can't afford that. But yet, we're going to throw a guy in jail for 20 years who's carried 30 pounds of pot across a state line in which that state may actually, pot may be legal. So it doesn't make a lot of sense. He's right on the idea.
You seem to be okay with what Holder's proposing here.
Well, the proposition's okay. I mean, we have to have this conversation now. But I just think that he's going to couch it in such a way that's going to make it very hard to sell to Congress.
What do you think, Leslie?
I'm in shock that I came here already to argue with Ro and we agree on some things. Mandatory minimums have been a problem in our country for a very long time. We have overcrowding in our prisons, and when you're putting somebody who is dealing or buying or smoking a lot of pot with murderers and rapists, when you look at the recidivism rate, you can't ignore the fact that the system is making perhaps a more hardened, violent criminal out of somebody who was originally a nonviolent offender.
The issue, do you blame the system, or do you hold your citizens more accountable?
I don't feel that the Attorney General is blaming the system, and I think it is his, and I do think he is the right messenger. As Attorney General, you need to look at the flaws in our system, and we have a lot of flaws. If you want to take care of the problems, we have a problem with violence in a society of violence within our prisons, and you need to say, okay, what are some of the contributing factors? And one of the contributing factors is overcrowding. Another problem is that we can't afford to have this overcrowding. So if you look at, say, can rehabilitation work for somebody like a non-violent offender who has some bags of pot, and it's not going to work certainly for a rapist or a murderer, most likely. That's something that he needs to do, and rightly so. He's not blaming the system. He's looking at what doesn't work to improve it.
Understood. You take issue with that?
Yeah, I do, because actually I think what he's doing is he's only going to be talking about a very small percentage of the prison population here. We are talking about the older people that he wants to let out. Now, that's interesting, because just as the federal government's about to get into the healthcare business, they're also saying, in the people that they are charged to take care of for the rest of their lives, they want them out because they don't want to pay for older patients who are prisoners. Now, the other side of this, though, is look at what he's doing here. The number of people that are actually incarcerated for 20 years for these small offenses, the nonviolent offenses, is a pretty small number. So what he's trying to do is he's trying to be political about this. This isn't really about overcrowding. We're 40% overcrowded at this point. Maybe he'll reduce it by 10%. That's just not enough.
Here's also what he says. It is clear, he will say, that too many Americans go to many prisons for far too long and for no good law enforcement reason.
That he's wrong about.
In addition to that, he'll say we cannot simply prosecute or incarcerate our way to becoming a safer nation. Leslie.
No, I agree with that. I live in California, where we have a three strikes law, and so I don't agree with Ro's numbers, at least here in the state of California. There are many people in this system for mandatory minimum simply because they were caught with a dime bag their third time around, for example, and that's street lingo, guys, for, you know, marijuana. You know, I know nothing about this person.
The cost of incarceration in 2010 was $80 billion. The Justice Department says federal prison population has grown 800% since 1980. He's going to make a case that this is a burden financially as well. Ro, is that an argument you can buy? Quickly?
Yeah, I mean, it actually is. We're broke. I mean, we all know we're broke. And if he really wants to incarcerate more people, what does he have to do? He has to build more prisons and hire more federal employees to man those prisons. So that really is a very compelling economic argument.
As you were talking there, Leslie's shaking her head. So I need to leave it there. We'll end on a note of agreement there. Ro Khan and Leslie Marshall, the Attorney General, set to make his speech today. Nice to see both of you. Thank you.
Thanks.
You too.